Hello, let me check who's there at the moment. Just the people. We're gonna wait for 3-4 minutes until everybody's in here, or at least some of us. And check. Something I wanted to say is that if you need to ask any question, we have a chat in here where you can leave the questions. And we will try to answer the questions at the end of the meeting, okay? I hope I'm gonna be around 30 minutes talking and maybe 15 answering questions. Okay, so as I said, I'm gonna wait for more or less 3-4 minutes just to wait for the people arriving late, and then we start. Let me check. I'm going to share the beginning of the presentation. Until we wait a little bit. How many people are we at the moment? Okay. Let's wait for a little bit more. As I said, for the people, for the newcomers, I will be waiting questions. I will be answering questions at the end of the session. So hoping to be talking for 30 minutes more or less, and then answering the questions on the last 50 minutes. A ver. One second, I'm gonna take a look at how many people. Well, we are at the moment 8. Okay, we're gonna wait for a little more time, as we were supposed to be a little bit more. So, I don't know if many of you have ever been in Valencia, but my duty is to sell you what we have in the city, just to see if you're able to come and discover it by yourself. That's the idea that I have in mind for tonight. And 10 people at the moment, 3 minutes, 1 or 2 more minutes and we start, okay? 1 second. Okay. By the way, if you wanna express your feelings, you can do these kind of things, like getting surprised by some of the different places you're gonna visit in this 30 minutes, or maybe have fun with all the information I'm gonna give you, whatever. Well, it's 4 past 6. I think we should start, and then the other people that could join us will be already joining us when we start, okay? So before anything, I'd like to introduce myself. My name is David. I'm the product manager for studies in Valencia Tourist Board. And I would like to spend some time with you, giving you different tips about the city. I'm not gonna be talking all the time. What I would like to do is just give you the chance to see it by yourself in the different videos that we have in this tourist office. So we're gonna start the presentation with the video, okay? This video is a resume of where Valencia is and the best possibilities that we have in the city, okay? So sharing. We start.
Things things in Valencia are incredibly thrilling. Valencia is here, on the coveted Mediterranean coast. Valencia is home to 135 kilometers of beach and lucky to have sunshine year-round with an average annual temperature of 19 degrees. When the moon runs down the summer sky. It is the third largest city in Spain, with an airport conveniently close to the city centre, which connects it to many destinations. And that's without mentioning its port, high-speed train, and its wide range of hotels. Valencia is warm and welcoming, ready to host you all year round with an extensive array of plans to choose from. With an offering of on-site and virtual visitor services. Ah, and the Valencia Tourist Card. Visitors have a very complete range of options. Valencia is really impressive. It is now and has been for thousands of years. It has tradition and modernity. The more you love, the more you live. And it already has three UNESCO World Heritage tourist attractions. Because culture permeates everything here. It has festivals that entertain the young and the old alike. And music in every corner. Valencia thrills. Have heard from the sky all about it. In countless ways. The high tide flows around here. Through the whispers of pines I hear them. Even in the salt water. As well as in the fresh water. Valencia gets around on wheels. It gets around in a different way. By being sustainable, breathing fresh air, and walking on green ground. The more you love, the more you live. In Valencia, tastes are cultivated. Between stars. And locally sourced products that go everywhere. Valencia is inclusive and accessible. Place to grow, to leave frontiers behind and reach out to the whole world. The more you love, the more you live. Have heard from the sky all about it. Valencia is a place to feel completely free, because only here can you find the best mix to bring out the best in yourself. Valencia is now.
Well, this is a nice video just to sum up more or less everything, okay? I'm supposed to be finished, but not. I will be talking a little bit about more things and giving you more details about Valencia, okay? Now I will continue with the presentation. Presentation that's here, 1 second. So now we saw the video. I'm going to give you a little bit of an explanation of the city of Valencia. As the video said, it was founded by the Romans. It was founded in 138 before Christ. And it was not built in near the sea. It was built near the river. It was a river that was 5 kilometers away from the sea. And right now we still have the river, but it's not a river with water anymore. I will give you the explanation later on. On the left, you have the image of what Valencia or how Valencia looked like before, 2000 years ago. It was totally Roman. And now we still have some of these remains below the city center. Right now, if you want to build anything, you have to be very careful Because 3 meters below the center, you will be able to find any kind of Roman ruins, and it's quite complicated to build over there. This is just located, the image on the right, is just located below the cathedral. So we still keep a lot of ancient roots. After the Romans in the 8th century, we were conquered by the Arabs, by the Muslims. So we developed our roots are part of this Muslim culture, which means that we have several kinds of influences from different places. After that, the Christians came down from the north of Spain and conquered Valencia again with Jaume I. And then since then, we have been Catholic since that first moment on. After giving you this explanation, you already know that Valencia is the third biggest city in Spain after Madrid and Barcelona, which are the well-known cities of the Spanish or the Iberian Peninsula. The population of the city is 850,000 residents in the city itself, but with the metropolitan area, we are around 2 million people. That's not bad at all, which means that we are not so big as Barcelona or Madrid. We are a smaller city, and the smaller cities have some kind of advantages too, because you are in a city that has almost everything and you can walk from one side to the other in maybe 1 hour. For example, in the morning, I used to go to the swimming pool that's just on the other side of my work. And then I take my bike, because Valencia is a flight city, and I cover from the north of the city, from the south of the city, sorry, to the north, in around 30 minutes. This is the time that I spent making around 9 kilometers by bike or biking. As the video said, it's quite warm and open. Not today. Today is raining. We are on one of these lucky days in the city, one of these 60 lucky days or 65, in which we don't have any sun at all, or we have clouded weather. But the rest of the year is quite warm, and the temperature is very good, as you can see in the pictures. These are normal pictures taken not only in the summer, but in other months of the year. It's quite weird to have rain in Valencia, but whenever it rains a lot. Affordable, as I said, we are the third biggest city in Spain. If you come to Valencia, you will be able to feel the difference or in your wallet regarding Madrid and Barcelona, for example, or other different main cities in Europe. So let's say that this is not a cheap city, but it's not expensive at all. And here you can go out to different places. And for example, if you want to have dinner, an average price for a dinner would be from 15 till 35 euros, depending on how much money you want to spend. But you can have dinner for 15 euros, and you can also have dinner for over 35, because we have, for example, 8 Michelin star chefs in the city, which means that if you want to spend money on food or really good gastronomy, you can also do it. Lifestyle, well, in these four pictures, I can give you like a different views. The one on the right is people sharing agua de Valencia. That's the traditional drink from the city of Valencia. This is a kind of sangria that we have in the city. Most of the people walking around Valencia will be used to watch people with the red jars at night, which everybody knows what it is. It is sangria. In our case in Valencia, apart from these red jars, you can see people drinking orange jars. These orange jars are a special liquid called agua de Valencia that's made of cava, orange juice, and some other strong drinks. Super tasty, but it's a little bit dangerous if you drink too much, because after 2 or 3 cups, you will realize that this is not only cava, so it's a little bit complicated. Then on the left, there's a concert in the City of Arts and Sciences. That's one of the main areas where we used to have concerts. In this image, you'll see around 20,000 people watching a concert in one of the pools, because the place where they are located right now is a pool with water. If you want to have a kind of concert, any kind of concert, we drain the pool and we transform this area into a festival area, as you can see. On the right, that's a new building that we have. It's the Agora. In the Agora, we have a big museum done by La Caixa. It's called Caixa Forum, and it's a cultural center. And then on the left, below, we have a lot of people running in the beach. As you know, Valencia is just in the beach. And we have several kinds of sports over there and different kinds of events and tournaments. I was telling you about the accessibility of Valencia. As I told you, Valencia is really flat. Right now, we have over 180 kilometers of bike lanes in the city, a flat city, which means if you want to move around the city, you can do it by scooter, like the lady on the left below, or by bike. You can also walk. There's no problem at all. We are connected with Madrid in an hour and a half, with Barcelona in 3 hours at the moment. In a few months, we will be connected with Alicante in 50 minutes. And at the moment, we have 850,000 passengers coming by cruises with over 300 stops, which means that the city is quite connected, not only in terms of moving around the city, because we also have 10 metro or subway lines combining train and subway, but also in terms of different airlines and flights. We are connected with around 100 airports, not only in Europe, but all over the world, mostly in Europe, as you can see, well connected with England, with Germany, with the north of Europe, with different places of the Mediterranean countries. Well, let's say that not only with the low-cost companies, but also with big companies like the ones you see on the left, and they are used as a hub to cover other places like Asia or America or the States. Most of the people coming from let's say South America, they used to come through Madrid with Iberia, and Paris is also one of the biggest hubs that we have in here. Just to let you know very quick, the accommodation offer, it's the one that you're watching here now, right now, 179 hotels. Next year it will be 190 because we are opening a lot of new hotels. As you can see, any kind of big brands and small hotels, many different things. The rooms are around 10,000, not really, but almost. And then the number of beds is around 20,000 again. Legal apartments, 6,505 beds, which would mean that altogether, without the with legal and illegal apartments, we will have around more or less 40,000 beds in the city. It's not a big number of beds, but enough to do different kind of events and enough to be a small city, not only a touristic city. On the left, there's like a round circle with a different, well, it's a percentage of the hotels that we have. Estrellas means stars, which means hotels, four-star hotels, 47% of the whole offer. And as you can see, the rest, I won't tell you all this small details. But for example, these two hotels that you see below, this is a four-star hotel that's called the Parador del Saler, where that's one of the best places to play golf in Valencia. And the one on the right is El Hotel Las Arenas. It was built in an old balnearium in 2005, and is one of the best hotels in the city. Ah, I was telling you about the river. This is the old riverbed. This is one of the main parks that we have, not only in Valencia, but also in Spain. It's from 9 to 11 kilometers long park that we have crossing the city from west to east. Why is that? Well, in 1957, we had a proper river crossing the city of Valencia. But during this year, there were like very complicated moments because it started a lot, it started to rain a lot. And we had really, really big floodings and a lot of problems. Over 200 people died in the center of Valencia. The water was covering more than 2 meters. And from then on, the authorities decided to divert the river. So right now we have the diversion of this river that's on the south of the city. And this old riverbed at the beginning was thought as a highway. our dictator Franco decided that it would be the best idea for us to have like a big highway connecting Madrid to the port of Valencia. That's just on the other side of town, and the goods will reach Madrid quicker with a big highway crossing the city of Valencia. But one of the main things of the population of Valencia, one of the main thoughts at the moment, was that they were not going to allow these kind of things, even if this opinion came from the dictator of Spain. They thought, okay, we need something different. We need a park. There were several demonstrations, and in the end, the population of Valencia became so important, and they were so hard against the opinion of Madrid that Franco decided that they will let us do whatever we wanted. Okay, in the end, we developed this old riverbed. There was like there were like several people in a competition trying to have like a proper model and a proper number of ideas for the river. And in the end, instead of picking up one of these ideas, as the old river has 19 bridges and there were 19 projects, they decided to give each of the architects just one part of the old riverbed for themselves in between bridges, which means if you come from the beginning until the end of the old riverbed and watch the different areas, you will see that in between bridges, every part of the old riverbed is different because it was built by different architects. In here, you can see one of the sides. Then on the right, you see people cycling. We have two bike lanes in the old riverbed. We have a running area. We have several sport tracks, football fields, rugby fields, many different things. For the tourists and for the local, is the main asset of the city. This is something very important for us. We have the City of Arts and Sciences, the city center, and many other things. But for everybody, the old riverbed is the most important thing of the city. Then I wanted to talk to you a little bit about national parks. Or natural park. The good thing about Valencia, as you see in the picture on the right on the map, Valencia is surrounded by three natural parks and the sea. So we have the Albufera Natural Park below, then we have the Turia Natural Park on the left, and above we have the natural park Sierra Calderona. This is also very good for us, because the city is not so, the good thing about Valencia is that we have a lot of wind from 12 o'clock more or less, and most of the area around the city is not so polluted. And this is very good for the population too. The natural park that are very close to us is an advantage for the people from Valencia, because we used to go to these other places to relax, and is, for example, the one on the south is 5 kilometers away from the city. The one on the left is starting on the old riverbed. That's so close to the city that it is inside of it. And the one on the north is 15 kilometers away from the city. So really relaxing places, but really nice too. The photograph on the left is like 3 kilometers away from the city of Valencia, but in the old riverbed. This is, as you can see, it's not the old riverbed. This is how it was, the former river, but the river was diverted when it was entering the city of Valencia. And this is the Albufera, the one on the south that I was telling you. It's important because I'm telling you a little bit about the story of La Paella after these photographs. And this is the way how you will discover why the paella is so important for us. All this water area that you see on the left is, they are rice fields, which will let you understand why we are, or why Valencia is the cradle of the paella, okay? Ah, before I forget, we have three UNESCO World Heritage Sites. Well, in this case, this is the Silk Exchange. Valencia was one of the richest cities during the 14th and 15th century. And this is one example of that. This is where people used to trade silk in the city, and they traded in an empty space. But during those two centuries, they decided to have a building specialized on that. In this building, we had a court and we had different things where people could connect with each other and sell the silk. This is what our first world heritage from the UNESCO. Then we also have the second one. That's a water jury. These eight people that you're watching on the pictures, they get together on Thursday at noon, every Thursday at noon, and it's the oldest jury in Europe. What do they do? Valencia has eight water canals, okay? And these eight people are the ones responsible for each one of the canals. Whenever there's a problem regarding water in the city, they are the ones deciding. So any kind of problem, any kind of trouble related with water, it would be solved in this jury. And there's no other jury above this one in terms when you're debating about or arguing about water problems in the city. They are the last one to appeal. So this is the reason why they are so important. It looks like a representation. It has part of it, but in the end, it is a proper jury. It's called the water jury, okay? And then the other one is Las Fallas. I have in here an empty space, but you know why I have an empty space is because I can give you a lot of explanation about that, but it's much better to watch a video. The video will be easy for you to understand what we do have in the city and what it will represent for us as a festival. It is the main festival that we have in the city of Valencia. And with this small video, you'll be able to take a quick look about it. Let me check now. Every day from the 1st to the 19th at 2 o'clock. I don't know if you like it or not, but you need to come to Valencia to discover it yourself. In a video, it's even complicated to let you know what a kind of party we have from the 14th till the 19th. These big monuments that you've seen, they're built on the 14th. And well, you won't believe it, but we burned them all on the night of the 19th. And then we start again. Burning them all, we burned the bad spirits and the bad things that people have in mind. And we start a new life on the 20th. Okay. Hope to see you here in Fallas. Anyway, I'm gonna continue with the presentation. We're about to finish, in fact. Again, let me go back to where we started. No, where we were. I told you that's the cradle of the paella. We have a unique gastronomy. Why the paella? As you saw, we have over there the Albufera Lake. The Albufera Lake is the one giving us so many rice fields. And why is the cradle of the paella? What people used to do in the past was very common. They took all the ingredients that they have close to them. So the traditional paella is made of meat and vegetables. You will see different kind of paella made of seafood, we have 80 ways of cooking rice, okay? But the traditional paella is made of meat. Meat means chicken or chicken and rabbit, and vegetables, different kind of vegetables, like the one, like the photograph you're watching in the beach, very close to me. And apart from that, we also have one of the biggest markets in Europe. I think it's the second one after the one in Budapest. For us, apart from the main market, that's the central market, we have 8 more markets, local markets, and that's where we buy the fruits and vegetables. And it is one of the most beautiful places in town. For us, with more than 100 years, the central market is key for the different chefs and people around the city. That's the place where we used to build, where we used to buy our goods, just to have different kind of foods. Before I forget, regarding the paella for us is always at lunchtime. Always at lunchtime. If you see anyone eating a paella for dinner, that won't be a local, okay? That will be a tourist for sure. Why do we have a unique gastronomy? Because we have a culinary culture based on local products, which means kilometer zero. You see the city on the photograph on the left, and you see the green areas around it. This green areas is a garden where we cultivate from chufa, that's horchata, something very special from us, to tomatoes, to orange trees, and many other things. And we get all these products directly from less than 2 kilometers away from the city of Valencia. In fact, our Michelin star restaurants, they are not using most of them many different kind of meat products, because the meat is not where we are strong at, but they are using mostly fish and vegetables that they can have very close to them. Then on the left you see then on the right you see Agua de Valencia, something very typical on the top, different kind of food that we can offer in a Michelin restaurant. Then I am going to let you see some pictures about the avant-garde venues. This is Valencia Conference Center. It was built by Norman Foster. Has a all this roof on the top is a photovoltaic roof, which means that we need no electricity for it, because it comes directly from the sun. It was built a long time ago, and it has been the best conference center in the world for 2 times. Then we have the Valencia Fair. Valencia Fair is the 4th biggest fair in Europe. As you can see, it's quite spectacular. The City of Arts and Sciences is a little bit more spectacular than the fair. This is on the first side you have in front of you is the museum, Príncipe Felipe, Museum of Modern, this science museum. Then on the left, at the end, you have the Opera House. I'm very close to it, and in between both buildings, we have the hemispheric, that's an IMAX. From here, you cannot see it, but it has the shape of an eye from one of the sides. This is the Palau de les Arts that I was telling you. That's our opera house with 4 auditoriums. And this is the oceanographic. This is our marine park with over 10,000 different kinds of species inside of it. And this is one of our new products, and that's the Roche Arena. It's going to be the basketball stadium, and they're still developing it. It will be finished in 2024, the beginning of the year, and it's going to be the best stadium in Europe by that moment. They have been working on it and visiting several stadiums in the state in Europe to have the best stadium at all. From this moment on, we'll have one of the best venues to do different concerts and other activities that are only going to Barcelona and Madrid, because we don't have a proper stadium as big as they have. Before I forget, we are the city of sports. I don't know if you know that, but the former weekend we had the last race of the MotoGP. That's one thing above on the left. We also held five editions of the Formula One. In Valencia, it was an European track from 2008 till 2012. We held two editions of the America's Cup, the 32nd and 33rd editions. In less than a month, I will be running, I hope, the Valencia Marathon again. In here, you have an image of it. This is 8:30 in the morning, 19 degrees, 4th of December. Let's see if this year we have no rain. From 2009, there has been no rain at all, and it has been under really good weather conditions. So we hope to have more or less the same image this year. We have also events expertise. We are at the moment World Design Capital and European Capital of Smart Tourism. This year, we also have the Goya Awards, which are the Spanish Oscars. And we will be hosting the International Council of Museums Conference in 2023. By the way, last week we were awarded with European Green Capital 2024, most of it because of 5 million green square meters. Then we also have the Gala of the Michelin Guide Spain and Portugal this year, and some other things related with sport. I already told you about the Formula One, about the America's Cup, about the Valencia Marathon. This is the 40th edition, has the same editions as the London Marathon. It's exactly more or less, it is exactly the same age, more or less. And this year, well, in 2023, we'll be hosting the 40th Rhythm Gymnastics World Championship in Valencia Fair. And by the way, in 2026, we have been awarded with the Gay Games. That will be one of the biggest events that we'll be hosting in the city. It's, an amateur multi-sport and cultural event. It will be 37 sports and over 20 cultural activities. And we are expecting around 12,000 participants and over 60,000 visitors for that. It's quite interesting because it's not just a competition for the community, but it is very diverse. It's open and everybody can participate. The only problem is the name. That's a bit complicated and it looks like a little bit exclusive because it's called Gay Games, but it's their brand. The proper thing about that is Diversity Games, which will be covering all the different people. Regarding the sustainability, we have been the first city in the world to verify and certify the carbon print activity of the tourist activity. And we have been like the pioneer of the cities in the world, and many other cities are following our steps and doing exactly the same, but at least we were the first one. Before I forget, we also have a high quality education offer. That's one of the main things that I wanted you to tell. We only have really big schools like the ones you're watching right now. The main ones are the Valencia University and the Polytechnic University, but we also have private schools like SIC, like EDEM, for example, like CEU Cardenal Herrera, or La Escuela Internacional de Protocolo. And on the one on the right is the Berklee College. I don't know if you have ever heard about the Berklee College in Boston. We have their only subsidiary in Europe. It's located in Valencia, very close to the city of Arts and Sciences. And most of the people that go to Boston, they have to do 1 year abroad. And this year abroad, you can imagine what it is, you know? On the other hand, we're talking about the language show in Valencia City. We have four Spanish schools certified by FEDELE. These ones are the first five that I have in this slide, but we also have four more on the next one. I can tell you, I've been in most of these schools, and some of them are located in very spectacular places. And their service is incredible. I don't know anyone that has been in these schools and has been not happy at all. They also do, apart from the Spanish lessons, different kind of activities. They can give you also the possibility to stay in a family. They have it all under control for you to experience the best week, the best month, the best year that you want to spend learning Spanish. Valencia, in comparison with other cities in Spain, in the city of Valencia, we all speak Spanish. In some cases, people speak a little bit Valenciano, but if they hear that you are speaking in Spanish, they change the language into Spanish, which means that for us, and on another point of view, is that when we speak in Spanish, our accent is quite clear. There are some places in Spain where it's complicated to follow them because their accent is quite strong, or they are like missing some letters because of their proper accent. Anyway, these are the other four that we have in the city of Valencia. And if you're not coming to the city of Valencia, but you're coming from there to visit the region, we have five more in Alicante. I was told that maybe six. And one more in Castellón, all of them certified by FEDELE, which is the national Federation of Spanish Schools. What else about the city of Valencia? Well, in here you have three more data. We have been, we are in the top 100 of the best student cities 2023. We have been awarded as best city in the world for Expat Insider in 2020. And as you can see, we are an Erasmus city. Only the numbers of Erasmus international students in these two universities, the Universidad Politécnica de Valencia and the Universidad de Valencia, is over 5,000. If we are 850,000 residents in the city, let's say that around 120,000 more or less are students, not international, but students. So we have a long tradition of people studying in here. This is good for us because if you have a lot of people studying, there are really good universities, and there are other specific and private universities that will be help you to develop and to be much better professional with their masters, MBAs, and so on. And to end up, I'm about to finish. I think I told you 30 minutes, but it hasn't been 30 minutes, but 40. I'm gonna let you see a last video, okay? And this video will be the last one. And after that, if you have any question, you can let me know whatever you think through this chat. This is only 50 seconds.
This is the year of the place where everything happens. It's the year of tourism that sees, lives, cares, and feels. It's the year of challenges that take your breath away. This is the year when all the stars in the sky shine like never before. The year of taste, creativity, and daring. It's the year of the best place to live when you know how to live life. It's the year of hospitality, diversity, and inclusion. Of smart tourism. This is the year of design you can touch, see, and feel. It's the year of all the things you can't miss, because this year, it all takes you to the same place. Valencia is now.
And that's all. So I hoped you enjoyed the presentation. I don't know if you have any questions. I want to check the chat. No questions at all. You still have some time to let me know anything you want. If not, you have my contact details on the web. It's you have over there my email and my phone number, just in case. So if you need anything else, there you have it. Okay. You're welcome, Timothy. I don't know. Anyone else? No questions. I hope to see some of you. And right now I cannot see anyone. I've seen that there are many people over there, but no chance to see anyone. I hope to see you in Valencia. Aileen, that's great. You can come back and I'll invite you to an agua de Valencia. And well, that was all that I had to offer. If you need anything else, you have my contact details, and I hope you can visit us and enjoy, okay? Nothing else. Come to the Fallas. I told you that the Fallas is great, but if you want to come to Fallas, be quick in doing a reservations because the prices of the hotels and the apartments and so on during these 4 or 5 days are quite high. So the sooner you book, do the booking, the better for you in terms of price. The rest of the things are fine. Prices of gastronomy and the bus and everything is same one. But the only thing that's a little bit more expensive are the hotels. And that's it. No more questions? You're welcome. Okay, then we finish right now, 47 minutes, 2 minutes after the expected time. Thank you very much. It was a pleasure to be here and give you a little explanation about the city of Valencia. I hope you liked it. And as I said, anything you need, I'm here, okay? Take care, have a nice day and enjoy the weekend. You're welcome, Daniela. Bye-bye.